We may not be fully aware of it, but our lives are built on access to affordable and reliable energy. For most of us, it goes unnoticed because the U.S. has some of the cheapest energy in the world. Now, imagine if access were limited or just really expensive. Affordable and reliable energy is more than just about convenience. It's about livelihood and health, touching on nearly every socioeconomic development issue we have today. Developing island nations across the globe are particularly challenged because many rely on imported and expensive diesel, which drives up the cost of electricity. If you use the same amount of electricity in Dominica as you do in the United States, your $100 bill would be closer to $400 per month for less reliable service. Oh yeah, and this electricity that you're paying a lot for is part of a bigger global problem. When diesel and other fossil fuels are burnt for electricity, they release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere and add to global warming. And although they contribute the least to carbon emissions, these low-lying, mainly coastal communities are most vulnerable to the effects of a warming planet and rising sea levels. The good news is, thanks to advances in renewable energy technology, there are more ways to bring reliable and affordable energy to people without adding to global warming. Even better, the price of renewable energy sources, such as wind and solar, are continually decreasing, whereas fuel prices can fluctuate drastically. Since 2012, the Clinton Climate Initiative has worked with a diverse group of partners and island nations to avoid an estimated 30 million liters of diesel consumption annually, install 25 megawatts of renewable energy capacity, develop a robust pipeline of clean energy projects, and increase access to new financing. The goal of the program is to put partner islands on a pathway to clean energy, where the vast majority comes from renewable sources. Not only will this work help developing island nations save money, it will provide a roadmap for communities around the world to reduce emissions and fight climate change. It's a win-win-win situation for island economies, for the environment, and for our shared future.